Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to talk about the frameworks and approach to measure or assess sustainability, and specific focus will be given to FAO SAFA guidelines. In practice, in the literature, the hundreds of different sustainability assessment frameworks have been developed by universities, civil society, national and international organizations, but most of them are usually challenged in getting agreement how to assess sustainability. Here I have presented some of the frameworks and tools, for example, life cycle assessment, biodiversity risk and opportunity assessment, global food safety initiative, and others. Actually, this expansion of sustainability tools place a burden on the producers and other stakeholders in the marketplace. That's why sustainability performance assessment is one of the most complex types of appraisal methodologies. Not only it entails multidisciplinary aspects such as environmental, social, and management, but also cultural and value-based elements. Sustainability assessment is usually conducted for supporting decision-making and policy development in a broad context, and is increasingly becoming a common practice in a product, policy, and institutional appraisals. But the implementation of an integrated approach to analyzing all dimensions, all sustainability dimensions, and integrating them into the business or the development strategies still remains a major challenge. And tackling this challenge requires a common language for sustainability, as well as the holistic approach to assessment and implementation that considers the complexity and the relationships of all dimensions of sustainability. So what does it mean? It means that to establish a common ground of sustainability assessment, a solid conceptual and methodological basis are needed. Why? Because sustainability assessment provides a benchmark for the production systems as well as a guidance for decision makers in revealing the synergies and trade-offs. So these guys did a comprehensive comparison of the scope and the precision of 35 different approaches identified in the literature, and concluded that no single approach serves all purposes of sustainable assessment. But in order to enable farmers to make sound decisions, all dimensions of sustainability need to be considered. If the tools are not harmonized, it means that the results from the assessment of different tools will be difficult to compare, and this will not allow the actors, producers in the food system to make the sound decisions about sustainable sourcing. So to close this gap, sustainable assessment of food and agricultural systems, or SAFA guidelines, were developed by FAO. Let me show you this guidelines. Okay, here we are. This guidelines consists of 368 pages and comprised of four dimensions: good governance, environmental integrity, economic resilience, and social well-being, and made of 21 sub-themes and 58 sub-themes with different sustainability objectives. For example, these are our themes. These are our sub-themes. For example, good governance dimension has 5 themes: corporate ethics, accountability, participation, rule of law, and holistic management. And each theme has specific sub-themes. For example, the corporate ethics has mission statement and due diligence sub-themes. And each sub-theme has specific indicators. For example, the mission statement sub-theme has 2 indicators. One is mission explicitness and mission driven. So each indicator has specific question like this. For example, for the mission's explicitness, the question is the mission of the enterprise articulated in all enterprise reporting and understood by all employees or members? Actually, in these guidelines, each theme and sub-theme has been presented one by one, and as well as the unacceptable stations and acceptable stations has been presented to the measure the sustainability or assessed entity. So based on these guidelines, an indicator-based multi-criteria assessment tool called SAFA Tool has been created by FAO. Actually, the SAFA Tool is free of charge and can be downloaded as a zip file at the FAO website. And I will put the link of that tool in the comments section for you to have a look. Let me show you how it works in practice. This is our SAFA Tool. So this tool starts with a description of the assessed entity and the boundaries of assessment and proper selection and application of the relevant set of indicators, followed by the determination of indicators' impact weights and finally the visual representation of the degree of goal achievement for each sub-theme based on the accuracy score. So let's start with the mapping. So the step one mapping consists of two main activities: the setting goals and the setting scope. Setting goals means defining the goals of the assessment and the description of assessed entities. The second, setting scope, means identifying the boundaries of what will be included in the assessment. So the second step is contextualization. Actually, a wide range of information have to be collected based on the context, meaning the geographic or regional circumstances, such as the climate and resource availability, as well as the socio-political circumstances, such as the labor trend and the legal framework, or such details and other details. So this information will also be used in this step in order to consider all relevant sub-themes and contextualize the indicators for assessment purposes. For example, in my case, I haven't used animal welfare indicators related to the animal welfare, because almost all interviewed farmers were the vegetable growers. In this case, there is no need to use animal welfare. The second step, the third step, is indicators, and this step includes the contextualized indicator list from the step two. And step three consists of the four main activities: selecting the appropriate tools and data collection, calculation of the accuracy score, and the selection and rating of the indicators and aggregation of the results. So this tool comprises a total of 116 indicators, but it does not mean that all of the indicators have to be used. But we have to bear in mind that indicators that are relevant must be used. So let's talk about the rating of the indicator and the calculation of the indicators. So for this, the color codes are used as a way of easy calculation. For example, if there is only one indicator in sub-theme, in case there is no need for weighting. In cases there are two indicators in a sub-theme, in the good governance, economic and social dimensions, the mean has to be taken of two scores. If mean is not possible, the lower score needs to be given. For example, if one indicator rates orange and another indicator is red, then the sub-theme must rate it as red. For example, let's suppose that there are three indicators in a sub-theme. And the maximum potential score for these three indicators will be 15. In order to rate the indicator, first we have to calculate the maximum potential score. Then we have to calculate the actual rating. For example, let's suppose that we have two indicators, two red indicator and one dark green indicator. In this case, our actual score will be 7. Because in our the red an acceptable station, the one have to be given. In the best dark green condition, the square of five have to be given. So if we have two red indicators and one dark green indicator, our actual rating will be 7. Then we have to divide the actual score by the maximum total score, and then we'll get 0.47. It means that 47%. So 47% is in, this is between the 40% and 60%, which corresponds to the yellow rating or the moderate performance. So if indicators which were deemed irrelevant with a clear justification could be omitted. And in this case, if one indicator is irrelevant in the subseam, which has 4 indicators, then the maximum score will be 15 instead of 20. However, if indicators are omitted which were not deemed irrelevant with a justification provided for each one, the resulting rating for the omitted indicator is 0% or unacceptable. So this score must be averaged with other indicator scores in calculating the subseam rating. If a subseam contains only one indicator, it was omitted without justification, then the subseam rating is 0% or unacceptable. If a subseam contains the 3 indicators and one is omitted without justification, a 0% or unacceptable score must be averaged with other 2 indicator ratings in order to determine the overall subseam rating. But for environmental dimension, this is for the rating subseams in the governance, economic and social dimensions. The calculation of rating is a little bit different in environmental dimensions. First, let me show you the combination of indicators in environmental subseams. In the SAFA guidelines, indicators are divided into 3 types: target-based indicators, practice-based indicators, and the performance-based indicators. So this following combination of indicators exists only in the environmental subseams. So these points here are given in cases when the best scores are achieved in individual indicators. That's why this table represents the maximum potential score for subseam in the environmental dimension. And this is the rating of the indicators by type in the environmental dimension. When the best score is not achieved in any of the indicators, the rating will be different. And all these three types of target, practice, and performance indicators have 5 scale ratings: best, good, moderate, limited, and unacceptable. For example, if we take a subseam, these 3 indicators, target, practice, and performance, and SAFA assessment of target score dark green, practice yellow, and performance yellow, then the maximum potential score will be 6. 1 plus 2 plus 3. But actual score, because we have 1 dark green, we have 1 practice moderate indicator, and we have 1 performance moderate indicator. For example, if we have, in the case of dark green, best dark green, then we have to give them the 1. Since we have the practice moderate yellow indicator, we have to give them 1. Since we have the performance moderate yellow indicator, we have to give them 1.5. So in this case, our actual score will be 3.5. So the final score for the subseam is 58%. And this is also between the 40% and 60%, which corresponds to the moderate yellow rating. So if any indicator is left unanswered, this is treated as the same. This is treated the same as unanswered indicators in the other dimensions. In SAFA guidelines, all indicators that are relevant must be used. if an indicator is not deemed relevant to justification, or enterprise is not a small holder who justifiably cannot access certain data, any unanswered indicator will automatically be considered unacceptable, or the 0% rating. The last step is the reporting. This. In the last step, all information from the previous steps is integrated into a performance report, and this process is called data visualization. Actually, data visualization is a way of presenting information in a graphical form and allowing to see the concepts and the relationships. Okay, guys, this is the end of our third video. In the last video, I will present a case study. I will evaluate the synergies and the trade-offs between the dimensions, between the sub-themes of sustainability by using Spearman correlation test. See you in the next lesson.